going?
Okay. Yeah.
How God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. God loves you today. God wants a relationship with you. He's knocking on the door of your heart. If you will humble yourself and open your heart, he says, I will come in and I will sup with you. He loves you so much. He wants a relationship. He wants to get to know you. And he wants you to get to know him. And once you know the Lord Jesus Christ, you will never do the same again. He will set you free. Who the Son sets free is free indeed. You might say, I've got sexual preferences that God doesn't approve of. Let me tell you, God loves every human being. He loves you today. Come to him. Humble yourself. Pride will keep you from God. Sin will separate you from God. But Jesus Christ came to this earth. He was God, made manifest in the flesh. He came to this earth to deal with the sin problem. He came to this earth so that we could be free. He cares for every person. He cares for you today. He wants a relationship with you. He loves you today. Do not despise what he's doing. Open your heart. Open your heart. Jesus loves you. Jesus cares for you. Do not ignore the call of God. The Spirit of God is here today at Macquarie. He's here speaking to people today because he loves you so much. He's got me here talking to you. I care for you. I love you because God loves you. And Jesus came to this earth and he dealt with the sin problem. The Bible says that God was made in the image of sin when Jesus Christ came to this earth. Jesus Christ had no sin. There's no sin in heaven. God doesn't allow sin in his heaven. He doesn't allow sin in his heaven. So when Jesus came to the earth, he was made in the image of sinful man. I'll say it again, the image of sinful man. And he dealt with sin. He condemned sin in the flesh. That's what happened. And he took the sin of the world upon himself. He took the curse upon himself. Jesus became a curse for us so that we could be free. Every person, it's available to every person. But you have to do something. You have to humble yourself. He will not force you. He does not want slaves. He does not want robots. He will not force you to come to him. But he calls you to repent. He says, repent. Turn around from the way you're thinking. People say there is no God. People say the sin I've committed is too great, that God won't love me. He does love you. He does care for you. He will forgive you. But you need to do something. You need to come to him. Come to him. All who are heavy laden. He says, I will give you rest. My yoke is easy. My burden is light. But you must do something. God has given you a free will. Your free will can take you to the pit of hell. God won't stop you. He doesn't want that. He doesn't desire that. His desire is that none should perish. But sadly, some people ignore that. Some people don't think they need God. Some people don't care. But God cares. He cares enough to have me out here speaking the good news. And the Bible says that the preaching of the gospel is foolishness to those who are perishing. If you think what I'm saying today is foolishness, and many people are walking by ignoring, many people are sneering, turning up their nose. One man even ripped out my microphone. He was angry, but at least he made a reaction. It's the ones that walk past and ignore, completely ignore, like they couldn't care less about the God of this universe, and they couldn't care less about their eternal destiny. If you cannot answer this question, where will you spend eternity? If you cannot answer that question, you're in trouble, my friend. Amen. Why?
Come and talk. Come, my friend. We'll help you.
Jesus loves you.
Come on, Jesus loves you.
People. He wants a relationship with you. He cares for you. He wants to protect you in this life. It's a hard life. He will take care of you. He'll put you under the shadow of his wing. You'll never know love like the love of God. People ignore it. They think that's just some fictitious thing. They're just Bible stories. But God loves you so much. He cares for you so much that he's got me here talking to you. And so the Bible, spreading the word of God, preaching the gospel is foolishness to those who are perishing. Are you perishing today? Do you think what I'm saying today is foolishness? If you think it's foolishness, you are perishing. You're in danger. Where will you spend eternity? You must be able to answer the questions. Because God loves you. God loves you so much today. He wants a relationship. And he wants a relationship with you. He cares for you so much. And he wants you to be saved. But you must do something. You must open the door of your heart. He's knocking on your door today and he's saying, if you will open the door, I will come in. I will sup with you. I will heal you. I'll give you power over sin. I'll give you new life. I'll give you power over addictions. But you have to do something. People, God will not force you. He's a God of free will. He does not want slaves. He does not want robots. He wants people who will love him out of free will. He cares for you, sir. He loves you, wants a relationship with you. He's knocking at the door of your life. Open your heart. He will come in and give you new life. He'll give you a clean slate. He'll wash away all that sin. He'll wash away all that bondage that's been on your life. He'll clean you up, give you a moral code to live by. It won't be living by our own truth. Everyone wants to live by their own truth. They want to twist the Bible. They want to twist the Bible around and make it God that suits them, that suits their sinful life. But God says, you don't need to do that. Come to me. I will give you new life. I will give you a new heart. I will take out the heart of stone and I will give you a heart of flesh. God loves you today, Macquarie. He cares for you. He wants you to have new life. He wants you to have a new way of living, new desires on the inside. He'll take away all the pain, the hurt that the world may have put on you, the hurt that your parents may have put on you, the hurt that your spouse may have put on you. God will take it all away. He'll give you a new life. He's knocking at the door of your life, young people. Open the door and let him in. He will save you. He will give you new power. He'll give you power over bondage, over sin. He loves you today so much that he's got me out here telling you, please do not despise what the Lord God is saying to you today. He loves you. People throw that word around. Love, love, love. Love is love, as they say in the LGB community. They don't know what love is. Real love. Love is tough love. Love is telling you the truth. I'm here today telling you the truth in love, that you need a savior. If you have sinned in your life, God is knocking at the door of your life and he's saying, I'll give you a new life. I'll give you new power. What is your moral code? Is it something you've invented yourself? You need a moral code that is the truth. You need the truth in your life. Not something you've learned on social media or you've learned from your mates or whatever it is. God's truth is the only truth that will sustain you. He loves you so much today, people. Many people just walk by and they don't care. When I say that God loves you, it just falls on deaf ears. But some people have their ears open. Some people have needs that only God can fix. Some people, most people, all people who do not know the Lord Jesus Christ have a gap inside themselves that can only be filled by a relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. Young people, open your ears. Open your heart to God. He's knocking on the door of your life. He wants to come in. He wants to be your friend. He wants to be your companion. He wants to be your mentor. He will teach you a new way of thinking, a new way of living. He'll give you a moral code that will protect you. You will step away from sin. You'll step away from the things that conform you to this world. This world will shape you. And you won't even know it's shaping you. You will be deceived by the things of the world. God will give you clear thinking, clear sight. You will have spiritual understanding that you do not have now. He will awaken something on the inside of you. He will fill a void in your heart that nothing else can fill. Nothing else. He will heal you and love you and protect you. Young people, you need protecting today. This world is shaping you. This world is shaping you in a way that is not good. Let Jesus Christ into your heart. He will bless you. He wants a relationship with you. Do not despise what he's saying. He loves you so much. He loves families. Your every relationship will be better once you have a relationship with Jesus Christ. Young people. Many young people just walk by and think, who's this crazy old dude? is talking about Jesus. Whenever I mention Jesus, people go all funny. But he loves you so much today, young people. He wants a relationship. No way about that. He wants a relationship with you and you. And he loves you so much, okay? And he wants to protect you. Let me tell you, this is a harsh world. And the world will shape you. You won't even know it's shaping you. It'll deceive you. But let me tell you, God will look after you. You need protection. People think, I need love, I'm going to put my body away. I'm being very frank, but don't do that. You don't have to do that. God will look after you. He will protect you. Take this and read it. He loves you and he wants a relationship. Open your heart to him, okay? He loves you enough for me to tell you. It's a really, really hard world, okay? But God loves you. He loves you. Let him get close to you. You need to get close to him, all right? Thank you for listening. Very listening. Good. God bless. God bless. There's some smart people in this world. You see those two girls? They're smart. I think they're smarter than you guys. Because they listen. They listen to what I said about the Lord Jesus Christ. Are you listening?
Come listen. Come to listen. Come join your friend. Join my husband.
tracks, you need seven more tracks?
Yes.
You need one to take and read yourself, okay?